Somebody say your name. I can't reach out to call you. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Viking 3 Series Product Lineup Virtual Training. This is your moderator, Margaret McSweeney, and before we begin the training, I'd like to go through a few housekeeping reminders as well as some introductions. Please remain on mute during the call. If you have questions, please utilize the chat function to ask questions during the training. All the questions will be answered at the end of the training presentation. For your information, we will be recording this training session. I'd like to first introduce Sue Bailey, the Director of Go-To-Market Strategy at Viking Range, and Nicole Cooper, who is the Showroom Manager at Middleby Residential's Irvine Showroom, Jackie Rothong, who is the executive chef and brand ambassador for Middleby Residential's New York showroom, and also Jamie Larita, the executive chef and brand ambassador for Middleby Residential's Chicago showroom.
Thank you very much, Margaret, and hello, everybody out there. I'm in a new environment today. We are in the 3 Series vignette here in our Chicago showroom. And I just love the 3 Series. But first we want to get to a recipe that was actually sent to me by Chef Jackie in New York City. What's so great about this recipe is the simplicity of it, right? It's like the good recipe, go-to recipe that you can depend on and also build off of. It's really sort of ironic that Jackie, you sent this recipe to me today because it reminds me basically of the 3 Series, right? Something really, really good and a basically good product that can build your kitchen life. So today we're going to talk about that recipe, and all it is really some white beans. Now, Jackie used canned beans in her recipe, which is fine. I always use canned beans in my recipes, but I also had some dry beans that I soaked overnight and then cooked on my 3 Series range until they were tender. And all it really is some zested lemon that I have here right added into the bowl, some fresh thyme. Today I have lemon thyme, which is really appropriate because it is using lemon as one of the main ingredients. And then I've got some really good olive oil. And when you want to use, olive oil in a dish, it's always good to use some really great. Today I'm using Spanish olive oil, and then just a little bit of salt and pepper to the dish. And Jackie asked for some toast points, so I also baked off some really nice sourdough bread in my 5 Series range today. And give it a little toss, and you are good to go. This would be delicious in of itself, or you can add some grilled shrimp to it if you wanted to add some celery or tomatoes or even some olives to it, some Kalamata olives. It's a great summer salad recipe, and I think it's a good one. So keeping it simple with that recipe, thank you very much, Jackie. And I think I'm going to pass this over to my friend Sue Bailey to start the training. Thanks, guys.
Hey, Jamie, thank you so much for that recipe. Guys, as always, I like to start the training giving you a little bit of history about whatever it is that we're talking about. And today we are talking about the 3 Series. From Viking. You guys that have been with me for quite a while will remember that many moons ago, we introduced the Viking Designer line. And Viking Designer was kind of that contemporary side of Pro. Now, when we introduced Viking Designer, it was actually introduced at the same price as Pro. There was no difference in the pricing. There was just kind of a difference in the look that you had it. Now, both of those lines were and still, are considered that ultra premium luxury line. Well, after a few years of having the designer line on the market, we realized that there was actually a larger need in the premium category, not the ultra premium category. So we kind of pared back the designer line. We reintroduced it as a tight line, meaning it only had 21 SKUs at that point. And we kind of focused on what we call a replacement kitchen, okay? Maybe it's a first kitchen. It's the smaller size range, you know, hood, dishwasher, and refrigerator. And that's kind of all that's in it. Jamie's going to talk in a minute about the design aesthetics and how 3 Series works from that standpoint. I'm focused a little bit more on the features. Now, at the time we introduced the line, we called it, for you guys that were around, we called it D3 for Designer 3, because we'd had Designer, then there was the second edition, and then we did D3. Now, D3 was truly meant to be that introductory line for that customer who wanted the Viking brand, but either they couldn't afford to have the Pro, or they wanted a more contemporary look, or something along that line. So that's why we came out with D3. Now, D3 had a unique handle and knob that actually had inserts. So guys, when we had the Designer line in D3, it didn't match anything within the Pro line. Well, once we were purchased by Middleby, we made the decision that the D3 line should become Viking. We changed the handle to match the Pro handle, the knobs to match the Pro knobs, and now it truly became that introductory piece. It's about this same time that we were working on the 7 Series range. So now we have this great lineup of a 3, a 5, a 7. Yes, comes from the BMW line, just because everybody understands. But 3, 5, 7 basically means good, better, best. So that's kind of where we went with this. We within the past 18 months, probably, you guys will notice, we've taken away the Viking professional logo that's on the product, and everything now is a Viking logo. The reason being, and we'll talk about it a little bit more as we get into the products, you know, a lot of times you might have a 3 Series cooktop with a 5 Series range, with a 3 Series refrigerator, whatever the case might be. We really wanted every product in our line to be able to work with the other lines, just in order to make it a little simpler. So what we're going to do right now, because another great thing about the 3 Series line is the way that it looks aesthetically and how you can put it in a kitchen. And I'm going to throw it back to my friend Jamie, because he is all knowledgeable when it comes to great design. So Jamie, all for you.
Jamie, we need to get you unmuted.
Yo, so we're unmuted. Thanks, Rich. So can you guys hear me now? Fantastic.
We got you now.
Okay, fantastic. So yes, Sue, thank you very much for that introduction to design. And when I first saw the 3 Series range, immediately it struck me as something that, you know, was very fresh, very contemporary, very streamlined. And I thought, wow. And as a matter of fact, when I designed this vignette that's behind me, I really thought millennial, right? Like, this is going to be a great range for someone that's young and cool and just starting out. But as it turns out, in designing the vignette and having the experience in the showroom, guys, it's really not just for that person. What I've come to find is that it's really for that person throughout their entire life. So what I mean by that is that you can start out with a great Viking product. Remember, that's the key. First off, it's like a great replacement, not even a replacement, but if I was flipping a home as a designer, having this available to me now, this 3 Series range, so important, because I can get that Viking logo in there and that Viking product in there. It's not just the logo, it's the product where we begin, right? And I know that when a customer or consumer walks into that space that I've designed, already the brand recognition is we're ahead of the game on that sale, as opposed to like a lesser brand. So there's that. But back to my point, I also think that this range you can start out with, and then as you budget through your life, especially now these days, it's nothing to be embarrassed about if you were to move and maybe put it into another small space. It's a 30-inch range, let's not forget. And then it's also a great range as you might want to downsize in life. I have plenty of people that come in the showroom that talk about, like, all I need is that. They still want that brand recognition. They still want to feel good and be attached to the luxury of it, right, with the brand. And they still need something that's dependable. Maybe they don't cook all the time, but they still want to stand next to or see that luxury item in their midst. So the 3 Series, from a design perspective, is really versatile. You can easily put this in any environment. I love the fact that You know, you have the nice clean look. The doors and the glass on this is different from anything else that we have. You got that nice glass black panel there. And then even pay attention to the shape here, guys, of the front here. That's a really chic, very contemporary new look that nobody else has. I love that you have that edge right there. And then also, you know, originally, like Sue was talking about, the 3 Series product line was Viking's solution towards something a little bit more transitional and contemporary. What's news to me, I didn't really know this, that it was the look before the Virtuoso line was even launched. So there's a little bit of history there for you. And now what's super exciting about this, guys, is, you know, normally it wasn't available. It was only available in black, white, and stainless. This was a special announcement here today that now you can get this range in all of the new Delta hues. So if you can imagine how beautiful this would be, let's call it maybe in you know, a really beautiful contemporary apartment, or even something by, you know, in a tropical environment. Look at that Bywater blue and how sharp that would look next to that window. I think it gives it a lot of personality on its own with the look of this product, but now available in all the colors, there's no stopping you as far as where you can put this range. So hopefully that gives you a little bit more insight on that. And I know we're gonna go to Nicole now in the Irvine showroom. Nicole, you're gonna show the, well, what are we seeing now? We're gonna see, okay, we are going to this nice panel of colors here. And you can see on this that we have all the different looks with all the different colors. And as you look at those, guys, think about, and gals, think about all the different environments that these ranges can fit into. I just love all of these colors. There's really, it's hard for me to pick a favorite, but some of them are the blues on the bottom and the new greens. And grays, of course, are even more contemporary. But as a selection, I think it's going to become difficult for consumers to kind of pick their favorite. So
I agree with you on that, Jamie. Exactly right. It was, you know, you only had this option in the 5 and the 7, and now bringing these colors into the 3 just open up a world of opportunity for the 3 Series. Very true. Good. Well, how about if we, Jamie, how about if we move on and start talking about some of the products in detail? Will that work for you?
That works for me, Sue. Let's do this.
Excellent. We're going to start, guys. You know me. I am always going to start with a range. I just think that it's what we do well. It is who we are. And so I love, love, love to start with the range. What we are doing, guys, is I'm quickly, you guys know how fast I talk. We're quickly going through all the products in the 3 Series line to make sure everybody knows what is available. What Jamie has there in the Chicago showroom is the gas range, 3 Series gas. The 3 Series ranges are available in gas, dual fuel, and electric, 30-inch size only. I do want to talk about the burner for just a minute. This is going to be one of the few features I kind of hang around on, because in a training a couple weeks ago, we talked about the 5 Series burner and the 7 Series burner. This is the 3 Series burner, guys. So the 3 Series burner is an excellent, it's a good performing, it's an aluminum burner, okay? One thing that's kind of fun about this for me is that our 3 Series, which is kind of our introductory line, uses the same burner that some of our competitors use on their very high-end ranges, okay? So this is a great burner. It is our, what we call our good burner, nice cast iron cap that is right there. You have, thank you, Jamie, you have the full grates. If you will, Jamie, pull that 5 Series burner over for me. I just want you guys to see the 5 Series burner. Remember, 5 Series is a brass burner, guys. That is a patented Viking burner, brass, cast iron, just a different material, okay? So the customer can start with the 3 Series is good. You can move to the 5 Series as the better with the brass, and then you move to the 7 Series as the best with the brass, open burner-ish, all those great things. So great burners, guys, whether you do 3, 5, or 7, excellent burners. What I do love about a 3 Series is the 5th burner. Okay, the 5th burner in the middle, we call it a fish burner, kind of unique there. You can do some, you know, longer things, longer pans. What I love is the accessory griddle. Now, granted, it's not big, guys, but it is big enough if I want to do some pancakes, if I want to do a small hamburger steak, anything like that. It is a reversible griddle with the grill mark on the other side and just fits so nicely on top of that. So for me, this is really a good functioning range. Perfect. Jamie, you do that like you've done that a couple of times before.
Yeah, that's true. Just a couple.
Exactly. So one of the differences, guys, between a 3-series range and a 5 or a 7 is that this does have different burner sizes on it. You know, a 5 pretty much has all the same with the exception of the 1 power burner. So this one is getting a little more into the different sizes from that standpoint. So that is one of the differences. This is the only gas self-clean range we still have in the line, okay? So if your customer says, I really want a gas range, but I really want self-clean, you're gonna bring them to the 3-series range because it is a gas self-clean. It does have a gas broiler in there, so also very nice. The other thing I love while Jamie's got that open is the range has got a great TruGlide rack, which allows for the easy removal of heavy bakeware. Very nice in there. I just see this come up. About 64,000 units. What's the BTU total on the range? About 64,000, if I've done my math right, guys. This oven cavity is a similar oven cavity to what we use in the 5 series. Okay, the racks are different from that standpoint. And the broiler is slightly different in this one in the all gas. So great, great thing there. You asked if the griddle is gas or electric. The top burner is gas. The griddle just sits over it. So it's not there's not a separate griddle to answer that question that just came in on the chat for that. Other thing to remember about ranges, there is an electric version of the range. So it's gonna have an electric oven cavity and it's gonna have an electric top that has the quick cook surface elements and those reach power in about 3 seconds. So guys, it's a great, great range for anybody who needs to use an electric range. Now, regardless of the range you choose, we've engineered for consistent and even baking combined with professional cooking power into each and every one of these ranges. Jamie, why don't you and Jackie just real quickly tell us favorite thing to cook on a 3-series range?
Go for it, Jackie.
Who's going first? Jackie, go ahead. Favorite thing to cook, 3-series range.
Favorite thing. I would have to say I love the fifth burner. So I would have to say pancakes. And the fifth burner is actually a huge selling point for us in the showroom. People are constantly like, well, this is great. Like I want 5 burners instead of 4. So it's a good thing.
And
good.
For
Jamie,
me,
what about you?
Yeah, you know, I'm old school guys when it comes to cooking. I'm all about like keeping it like when I was in the Culinary Institute, I was able to get one of those really nice fish poachers, right? So me, I love poached salmon. It's one of my favorite things with a little bit of hollandaise sauce, a classic dish. Having the ability to put a proper fish poacher on top of this thing is really wonderful. I'm not gonna lie, I probably would even heat up my wood chips in my smoker on the top of that fifth burner too, because it's something else. It's a different shape, right? So you're getting a lot of surface fire.
Excellent. Great. Thanks for that, you guys. We're going to move on to refrigeration, guys. I'm kind of going out of order a little bit from what you guys are used to me doing, just because we have it there. Great, Jamie. Love this freestanding French door. You guys know we sell boucoodles of French door freestanding refrigerators. A lot of times the customer just does not have the height to do an 84-inch high built-in refrigerator. So this one of the things I really love about it is, as we did in Chicago, you can do the accessory grill and side trim and make that baby look like it is a true built-in refrigerator. And so that is one of the great features of that. I also love, if we'll open up that refrigerator, Jamie, the other things I love here are the 2 humidity drawers and the temperature control drawer. That is one of those things that I just really, really like in this particular piece. So you can set the temperature on there to be colder or warmer, depending on what you're gonna keep within that drawer itself. And then the 2 humidity drawers allow you to increase or decrease humidity, as we talked about when we did the 5-series refrigeration, depending on if you've got leafy greens or things that have peels or whatever it might be, fully adjustable from that standpoint. Also, the other thing that people ask us for all the time that we don't have on the 5-series is gallon bin door storage, okay? You're never supposed to keep your milk in the door because it is the warmest place, but every customer wants to keep their gallon milk in the door. So you do have that ability for gallon door storage in the refrigerator, which is great. Excellent. We're going to keep moving just because we've got about 10 minutes left. I want to make sure we hit all the products. Let's go. Oh, I'm sorry. Stay there, Jamie. The electronic controls. I do want them to see the electronic controls on that right there. So easy access, guys, with the electronic controls. There is a filter alert there. So it, when your water filter needs to be changed, that will come on. There is also a small air filter, nowhere near the purification that we use in the 5 or the 7, but still just a small air filter within that. And the other thing I do love about this piece is the drawer on the bottom. It is such a large capacity freezer drawer, and you've got the drawers on the bottom. You've got the wire shelf. Look at the ice bucket. Will hold quite a bit of ice within that ice bucket. So it really is a great refrigerator. Very nicely done, Jamie. I like your shoes, by the way. Your shoes are nice, Jamie. You. I just noticed them like those very much. So great refrigerator. It is. Great refrigerator. Perfect for whether it's a Viking 5 series kitchen or 3 series kitchen. This is the perfect refrigerator for both of those kitchens. Now, Jamie, I'm ready to go to the dishwasher. Cleaning up after dinner party is nothing anybody loves to do, but I love the Viking dishwashers because, guys, I don't have to rinse stuff. You just scrape it off, you put it in the dishwasher, and the dishwasher is going to get it clean. That is one of the things that I truly love about the dishwasher. This is the 3 series, meaning, guys, there's the 2 racks. If you have a client that really wants the 3rd rack or they want their dishwasher to dry, you're just going to step them up to the 5 series dishwasher because, again, it's going to work in every kitchen. They look exactly the same from the outside. This has got a lot of flexibility when it comes to loading. You can still hold your wine stems in there. The cutlery basket on the bottom rack does move. Easy for you to place it wherever you want to. That's one of the things that I move around a lot in my dishwasher, depending on what else I'm cleaning. If I've got a lot of pans, if I've got a lot of plates, I can move it anywhere I want to across there. It's a nice touch screen to be able to actually start the dishwasher. Remember, if you order the VDWs, it comes with this wrapped stainless steel door panel like you guys are seeing here. If you wanted to do a color, because maybe you decided to do that Bywater blue that Jamie talked about a minute ago on the range, you would just order the FDWU and then order the panel that's painted and it can be on there that way. So you can do a colored dishwasher panel in a 3 series kitchen if you need to. Great job on the dishwasher. Good, all right. I think we're gonna say goodbye to Jamie for just a moment and we're gonna head to across the country, watch how quickly we get there, to Nicole. Hello, Nicole, beautiful Nicole is there. Jamie, I do want you to jump in here, though. Let's talk about this slate blue color in this oven for just a minute.
Oh, absolutely. Guys, this is something that instantly takes that 3 series oven, wall oven, to a luxury level. I'll never forget the day that we got it installed and we unwrapped it, and Jessica Alt and I almost gasped when we saw it because it's really in this color especially. And I believe it's going to happen in most of our colors, if not all. It really took it up. And if you pull back a little bit, Nicole, so we can see the whole top and bottom of that oven. Thank you so much. It really takes the 3 series to a whole other level. Super, super sleek.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. So that's a slate blue for anybody who hasn't had a chance to see it live. It is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Now the ovens, guys, for the 3 series, it is a completely different oven chassis than what we use on the 5 and the 7. Still a very, very good oven. Okay. It's got a good convection fan, fairly large, not as big as our 8.5 in the back. It does a great job when we're working on it. So we have single and double. Remember that 3 series is only a 30-inch oven. If your customer needs a 27-inch oven, they're going to have to go to a 5 series. They do, both the single and double ovens have a powerful 10-pass broiler. It has got True Glide racks in there, and it also has a true convex setting, guys. So for those times that you, hang on, my dogs are starting to bark, even though I'm in the closet by myself. Okay, so we've got True Glide racks that will pull out that true convect, which is where I was. You can do multiple racks at the same time. Great, great oven cavity. that we have there. And now I think we're going to move on to the cooktops. We're going to let Nicole kind of walk just a few minutes into cooktops. Let's talk about cooktops for a minute, guys. We have gas and electric cooktops. That is the gas cooktop. If we stay here for just a second, Jamie was talking on the range about that curve. I love the curve. And you guys that have been around a while know my husband designed this whole line of products. And that curve was just so instrumental in getting the look just the way we wanted it. There's 30 and 36 inch gas cooktops. They are both a 5 burner. Okay. So you don't lose anything from that standpoint. They do have the similar aluminum burners like we saw on the ranges. So if you know that burner, you'll know it here on the cooktop also. So just a very, very nice look in there. You can fit a really large pan on that middle burner, which was the whole idea when we designed it, was to be able to get a really large pan and not encroach on those other burners that are next to it. So I think that that is just a great, great cooktop. Now she'll walk on down to the electric. Here's what's funny for me, a little tidbit of information. I ask this a lot of times of the sales team to see if they know. This electric cooktop comes in 30, 36, which are both 5 burners, and a 45 inch 6 burner electric cooktop. Guys, through the whole Viking line, whether it's 3 or 5, the 45 inch cooktop is double the sales of any other cooktop, including our pro ones in the electric category. So people love, love, love the 45 inch electric cooktop that we have. Notice again, the great curve that we have there. They are triple and dual elements, easy to clean glass, and these do heat quickly. Within about 3 seconds, they're up to full power. So it is wonderful from an electric cooktop standpoint. A couple of other things in the built-in cooking that we have, we do have electric warming drawers in the 3 series. Now guys, this is not the digital control with the meat probe that we have in the 5. This is a basic warming drawer. It goes from 90 to 250, does everything you need, but it is in the 3 series. And there's also conventional microwaves with optional trim kit and conventional and convection microwave hoods, as we see right there. So that's a great look there, Nicole, of the microwave hood over that 3 series range. So that is a wonderful shot right there. That leads us into the ventilation. So the microwave hood, the OTR, is one of the options for ventilation in the 3 series. The one I really love is the 12 inch high chimney hood. And Nicole's gonna make her way towards that. There we go. Look how beautiful that chimney hood is in that color. It is fabulous. And notice this, guys, we did that chimney hood. Well, I take credit for what Jamie does. Jamie did that hood over a 5 series range. This is what I'm talking about, guys. The 3 and the 5 just work so well together that the customer no longer has to pick and or has to decide which series they want. We make sure that they're all going together. So that is a great, great look. Difference between the 3 series hood and the 5 series hood. The 3 series hood uses the mesh filter, where the 5 series hood uses the baffle filter. These are dishwasher safe. They pop out very easily. You can see it. Great shot there, Nicole. You can see it there. You've got variable lighting. The blower has some settings, more than one setting. LED lighting. It's just a very, very simple, easy to use, easy to clean hood that is excellent to have. Guys, it does have the heat sensor that we talked about last week when we did the ventilation. So you do get the heat sensor also in this one. The other thing that we have is we do have downdrafts. The downdrafts are in the 30, 36, and 45 inch to match these cooktops that we have. You can do those behind a range, and I'm not going to tell you anything else about that because we're going to do downdrafts in a coming up virtual training. So I'm going to save all of that for later. The downdraft does have a great LED light that makes the surface easy to see from that standpoint. Last thing, I've got like 30 seconds. Last thing I want to tell you is one of the other things I love best about a 3 series is, guys, you can get a full Viking 3 series kitchen for under $10,000, or $9,396 to be exact. And with that, I am done.
Good job, Sue.
Yes. Thank you, Sue, and thank you everyone for attending. Please make sure to catch Chef Jamie and Chef Jackie on the Viking Facebook live feed for an amazing cooking video on Wednesday and Friday evenings. Viking, Middleby Residential, and Sherwin-Williams invite you to a special designer-focused webinar introducing the Delta Hues Contemporary Color Collection from Viking and a discussion regarding color, great design, and delicious food. This webinar is next Tuesday, June 30th at 3 p.m. Central Time. Spaces are limited, so contact your local Viking representative for login details. Please also make sure to tune in for our next Viking virtual training on Thursday, July 9th at 3 p.m. Central Time on the Viking 5 and 7 series ranges. Look for a follow-up email with assets from today's training as well as Chef Jackie's white bean salad recipe. And a reminder, we are hosting virtual showroom appointments out of our Chicago and Irvine showrooms. Visit our websites or talk to your Middleby Residential District sales manager for more information. This concludes our training today. We will remain on the call to answer any questions that you may have asked now or in the chat. And we'll check. Someone asked, what is the warranty?
Sorry, I couldn't unmute myself for some reason. I don't know why. It was my fault. On all the Viking produced product, it is 2-year full. On the refrigerator, it is a 1-year full.
Great.
There was a question on the chat also about, do we have a range with 50,000 BTUs or less? That always comes from somebody in New York, because there are some places that can't have that many BTUs. And so honestly, the 60,000 is probably the least that we have on that VGIC, now that I think about it, from a range standpoint. So that would be the last there. Ruth asked for us to explain a little more on the 357 difference on ovens. Don't know that I have time to do that, Ruth. We'd be happy to send you the training. That they're just basically use two completely different convection systems from there. So we can get you that training if that would help. What else?
I didn't see any other questions. As always, you are so thorough. It's great.
Thank you. Good. And I guess we're all taking off for the 4th next week. So I will talk to everybody 2 weeks from today, I guess.
Yes, and anybody that's on the phone right now, I forgot to add the lemon juice to the recipe, but don't forget, add the lemon juice.
Nice save, Jamie.
Thank you. Have a happy 4th of July, everyone. Thank you.
Bye,
so
guys.
Much.
Thank
Bye.
You, folks. Give to the one living now. Again, tonight, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the one day today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back all the memories. Bring back memories, bring back your. Memories bring back, memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost. I felt all the hatred, just about for a star. And my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for you, but you know I'll never drop. Yeah, everybody hurts sometimes. Everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. Everything will be alright. Only the person say, hey. Here's to the one that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here tonight. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the one day today. echoes to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your.